In this video, I'm going to attempt to use surface modeling to add these spiral features. These features blend smoothly to the top and to the bottom of the main body. At the same time, there is also a smooth transition between one spiral to the next. We shall start with this main body that was created using a simple revolve. First, we are going to address the spiral shape. To do that, let's make use of this sketch. Activate the surface workspace. Go to Create, Sweep. Remove the chain selection option so that we can select entities individually. Select the horizontal line as the main profile. For path, click on the select box and select the vertical line. Adjust the twist angle to introduce a spiral. Set orientation to perpendicular. The path where the surface body intersects with the main body is the path that we need. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these faces of the main body to split. For a splitting tool, click on the select box and select the surface body. We need this to be a bend. Go to Create, Pattern. Circular pattern. Set object type to features and select the split face as the feature. Y axis, click on the select box and select the Y axis. Set distribution type to partial. Adjust the angle and quantity. We are going to use this sketch to split off the top and the base. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these two faces. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Make sure that you are still in the surface workspace. Select these two faces and press the Delete key. This removes the faces and the body becomes a hollow surface body. We are going to create a sketch profile that represents the cross-section of the spiral feature. Go to Construct, Offset Plane. We want the plane to be parallel to the top plane, so select the top plane as a first reference. For the second reference, click on this point. Create a sketch on this new plane. Select this arc. And press P to project. Let's hide the surface body for clarity. Click on Look At in the sketch palette to look normal to the sketch plane. draw a straight line to join these two points. Set this to construction. Draw another straight line from the midpoint of this line and make it perpendicular. Change this to a construction line as well. Draw a 3-point arc from this point and end it in space. Mirror this arc across a perpendicular line. Create another 3-point arc tangent to these two arcs to close the profile. Bring back the surface body. Go to Create, Loft. Remove the Chain Selection option to select edges individually. Select this edge as the first profile. Select the sketch as the second profile. Select this edge as the third profile. Click on the select box for rails. Select this edge as the first rail. Select this edge as the second rail. For profiles 1 and 3, set the continuity option to tangent and align to surface. This will blend the loft smoothly into the top and bottom of the main body. For both rails, set the continuity option to tangent as well. This ensures a smooth transition between one spiral to the next. Bring back this sketch. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the sketch as a trim tool. Select this portion of the main body to remove. Go to Create, Pattern, Circular Pattern. Set Object Type to Bodies. Select the loft as the main body. For axis, click on the select box and select the y-axis. Remember that we use an angle of 20 degrees to create the split bend, so we need a total of 18 bodies to create a full revolve. We now have a fully watertight surface body. Go to Modify Stitch. Select all surface bodies and stitch them into a single solid body.